Here we have two companies of T-62s and a battalion of mechanized reserve infantry, minus the weapons company. Mortars and off-map rocket artillery are also at my disposal. This is the area we will be fighting over. Three clusters of buildings are the objective and the terrain is fairly open. I have some prior intel, since this is a Syrian assault. Two hills and a wooded ridgeline frame my targets. Initial battle plan. There is a large ridge separating my forces from the objectives. It is lightly wooded, but exposed to almost all of the defenders' strong points and overwatch positions. Attacking over it will be suicide. So the plan will be to hit three of the enemy positions with rocket artillery, heavy barrages for maximum damage, while a scout platoon will attack the ridge and take up overwatch to give me a better idea of what I am dealing with. On the left, one tank company will prepare a support position for my main attack, which will be the other tank company along with two infantry companies. They will use the ridge as cover as they storm up the left flank. Shielded by the terrain, my numbers will overwhelm the defenders on the hill, and from that hill I will attack the objectives, one by one. Round one. Begin. My scouts disembark. Tank Company Angel will be supported by the machine gun platoon of Bravo Company. They will act as scouts for the old tanks. Each weapons team has a spotter with binoculars. They will relay their sightings to the platoon leader, who will relay it up the chain of command. Thus, my Angel Company should not crest that hill blind, but aware of any enemy forces lying in wait. They immediately come into contact with a German Leopard. The German tank is a horrible threat to all of my forces, and the best I can hope for at such a long range is a weapon kill. The odds are not great. On the other side of the hill, my force is getting organized into support and assault groups. It might be better to close the distance early. Ibex's Leopold is behind the brown hill, so I might be able to rush closer without it getting a line of sight on my assault force. The PKM teams are not enjoying their role as scouts. They should hurry up and tell their platoon leader what they see. Angel Company needs to know before they can lend support. Tank Company Bull is kicking off their attack, along with Charlie Company of the Mechanized Reserve. Angel Company moves to support. Let's hope they know what to look for. Bravo Company will soon join the assault. First blood. There are more than one Leopold. The infantry has Panzerschrecks. The supporting Angels are being destroyed. They never saw their Deathbringers. Trench. We need softening up before another attempt is made to take it. EMPs will hammer it while fresh infantry is brought up. The next assault will be a combined arms attack. EMPs will move in with the human wave. And the rocket artillery has sent in their next barrage. First step is complete. I have taken the slope facing my forces, destroyed what seems to be a platoon of infantry. Ground gained while suffering acceptable casualties. Now comes the hard part, closing in with Epictus Leopold and destroying them. Infantry will screen my tanks, hopefully gaining a spot. Because the Leopold can kill up to 5 of my tanks per minute. The leftmost backs away. I must weigh between carefulness or aggressiveness. My tanks will crush holes through the cobbled wall, clearing a path for my BMPs to flow through. No time for carefulness. I must press onwards. The trench assault BMPs are exposed on my right. They feel the wrath of another Leopold on the faraway rightmost hill. I'm taking a brutal beating by phantom tanks, knocking out everything I sent over the hill. I will attempt to rush on the lowland to the left and flank the visible Leopolds while I also pressure the front. The leftmost Leopold seems to have disappeared, and I keep on losing armored vehicles. Thank you. But I know where the other one is, though. Get in close, boys. Bayonets and righteous rage. Yes, we have wounded the tiger, but at great cost. I call in the reserve. I call in Alpha Company. The attack is failing. The men flee. Alpha Company must get here quick, or the battle will surely be lost. As the first BMP of Alpha unloads its infantry, Ibex goes on the counterattack. Leftmost Leopold is spotted again. There is no front line, only chaos. His tigers are surrounded by my infantry. And with the humble RPG-7, they slay the beasts. The hill is mine. Two Leopolds dead, along with all of my tanks and most of my BMPs. Step two is complete. Now I must rally the troops and get them ready to assault the real objectives. I think I have about two companies worth of infantry. half of them broken, and a company and a half of BMPs were no match to the faraway Tigers. They face an unknown number of German infantry, two Leopards, and a few of the little toy tanks. But I have the hill, and it will shield me from most of Ibex's forces when I finally attack the first objective. Mortars will also provide cover. The plan is the same. Concentrate all of my fighting power on a small portion of Ibex's defenders, screened by terrain and other buildings. If done right, only one other housing cluster will be able to support the target. It will be shelled by mortars to suppress them. The other clusters should have a harder time of lending support. Buildings screen their vision, and even the faraway Tigers could be blind. But first, I must reorganize, regroup, and rally. It will take a few minutes. The first part of Operation Scimitar has been a blast. A bloody, brutal affair. Ibex made the mistake of underestimating my force and paid the price of two Leopards for that lesson. But there is more to come.